WYFF News 4, live local breaking news at 6.
Get ready for storms. Good evening. I'm Carol Goldsmith.
And I'm Nigel Robertson, in for Michael. And we are already seeing those storms in the mountain, and things are changing quickly for the upstate.
News 4 Chief Meteorologist John Cesarich is here. John, what's going on?
Yeah, Carol and Nigel, these thunderstorms have continued to march across the western North Carolina mountains, now moving into the mountains of South Carolina and northeastern Georgia. These thunderstorms have had a history of producing lots of lightning, extremely heavy rainfall, large hail. In fact, I had some reports of some of the hail as almost a golf ball size hail. And we had 65 mile per hour winds earlier when these thunderstorms moved through you folks in Waynesville. So these thunderstorms have had a history of producing damaging winds and large hails. They continue to move off to the southeast at about 35 miles per hour. So they're going to slide right down into the northern part of the upstate here over the next hour or so. Here's where all the warnings are right now. In the yellow shaded area, you remain under a severe thunderstorm warning, and we'll certainly keep you updated throughout the newscast. Now back to you, Carol.
Thank you, John. An allegation tonight about a major development in downtown Greenville. Concerned neighbors say the city plans to make room for the project by selling public land that's not supposed to be for sale. News 4's Myra Ruiz is live and local in Sky 4 over downtown Greenville tonight. Myra?
Chances are, if you've been walking through Main Street in downtown Greenville, you've seen this huge fenced-off area that starts at Coffee Street. Well, we're talking about some new development there, you may remember. Wait, why don't we take a look down there? Well, basically, legal documents from 1988 show that the city acquired this property known as Piazza Bergamo by promising to use it as open public space. And this other part over here of a leather stretch of it shows that in 2009, the city bought a stretch of this property along the side of the fence to use this as public space. But it turns out now that plans for this major project will change that.
This is phase one, and this is phase two.
Anthony Conway and other concerned citizens created a scale model of a major development that will fill the old Woolworth site on North Main Street in Greenville.
I think it doesn't fit. It doesn't go with any of this, like here on Main Street. You know, it's like a sore thumb.
But what's turning into a sore subject for some is how part of the private development...
I was hoping for a park. I was hoping for a city park. Like they have in downtown Nashville.
...will cover what is currently public space. Anthropology will stretch into the plaza.
This is really like a David and Goliath situation. You have a powerful business leader and City Hall seeming to work in concert to do something that's totally against what everyone else in our city wants.
On Tuesday, the city's design review board approved the architect's plans. Board Chair Barry Knox told News 4 other decisions yet to be made will not be up to the board. He said, quote, "The city and the developer are involved in several land swaps. This is work for the city's attorneys to work with. It's a legal issue dealing with land ownership and any restrictive covenants and how they're interpreted and applied." Conway referred to documents which he says shows this space is supposed to remain open public space, not open for public shopping.
So there's no way that this is available to anybody for private use.
Well, city staff members tried tracking down someone to speak to us about this, but no one called us back. Myra Ruiz, WYFF News 4, live in Greenville.
An Anderson County man is in jail charged with shooting his brother. Deputies charged Billy Pearson with attempted murder. He's in the Anderson County Detention Center waiting a bond hearing. Deputies say Pearson shot his brother yesterday at a home on Camelot Drive in the Star community. Investigators say Pearson had gotten into an argument with his brother Jimmy. Jimmy is at the hospital in critical condition.
Funeral services were held today for the man many knew as the father of modern Greenville. Max Heller died on Monday. He was 92 years old. As News 4's Gabrielle Komorowski shows us, hundreds turned out today to say goodbye, but also to celebrate Max Heller's life.
So many people came to the funeral of Max Heller, extra chairs needed to be brought in to the synagogue of Congregation Beth Israel.
Everybody in Greenville felt like he was their best friend.
Hundreds came to say goodbye to the former Greenville mayor.
We will always remember him as Mr. Greenville, the man who helped to make Greenville what it really is.
The man who was intent on keeping downtown Greenville alive and keeping businesses here.
We're losing a truly great, genuine individual who believed in the community and the people.
But on this day, Heller's success as a community leader was temporarily set aside. This was a day to talk about a man who loved his family, his wife Trudy, and dancing.
I remember Sunday mornings my parents would put Viennese waltzes on and dance through the house.
Heller's three children, 10 grandchildren, and 15 great-grandchildren spoke about the man they called Poppy Max. Heller escaped the Nazi Holocaust in the 1930s and became mayor of Greenville in the 1970s. The funeral procession paused in front of the statue of Heller on Main Street before he was laid to rest.
I think he'll still continue to get the credit for the awesome city that we have for years to come. Everybody will remember him, and I hope we can keep that memory alive for people who've never got the opportunity to meet him.
In memory of Max Heller, a black ribbon is tied in front of City Hall today.
This evening, concerned citizens are gathering at Seneca High School to have their say about protecting Lakes Jocassee and Kiwi. Duke Energy's license to operate its hydroelectric project expires in 5 years. The relicensing process begins now. But before that can happen, federal officials want to hear from the public. The Federal Energy Regulatory Commission approves the license, so it's holding public hearings to get community feedback. Officials are making sure use of the lakes is balanced among recreation, producing electricity, and water supply.
We have a number of interests that I'll list here. Those include endangered species, aquatic habitat and wetlands, water quality, migratory birds, shoreline habitat, and littoral enhancement, as well as fish communities.
The second of two public hearings today is now underway at Seneca High School. It ends at 9 p.m. Anyone interested in sharing their concerns about the lake is encouraged to attend.
A former Spartanburg County teacher is back in jail tonight. Deputies say Sarah Jane Lindsay violated her home detention. Lindsay was a kindergarten teacher at Boiling Springs Elementary. She resigned in September after being charged with 9 counts of contributing to the delinquency of a minor and criminal sexual conduct with a minor between 11 and 14 years old. Deputies say Lindsay corrupted students at parties with alcohol, drugs, and sex. She was ordered under home detention until her court date. Deputies say she left her home without permission and could not give them documentation of where she went on May 24th. Lindsay must now stay in jail until she goes to court.
In the upstate, one gym is slimming down, another one's gaining weight. ZX Fitness is closing down its locations in Spartanburg and Greenville counties. The spokesman says it wasn't possible to negotiate long-term leases. Thanks to a new deal, the 8,000 or so outstanding memberships will be accepted as is at Coop's Health and Fitness locations in Greenville, Spartanburg, and Anderson. To make room, Coop's in Greenville is adding a new parking lot, and around 55 jobs will be added across all three locations.
How many local businesses are going out of business due to the economy or due to other big box franchises? And for Coop's, who is local, a local business, I'm born and raised here, lived here all my life, it's an honor and I'm proud.
Coop's officially takes over the ZX memberships on July 1st. Starting Monday, Coop's staff will be at the ZX locations answering questions.
High school students from the Carolinas and Georgia got a hands-on lesson in leadership and teamwork today. 34 rising high school seniors renovated the United Way Gifts in Kind Center in Spartanburg County. They also interviewed and shopped with representatives from area agencies that the center serves. It was all part of the Milliken Wofford Summer Leadership Institute, which aims to teach students skills they would not learn in school. This year's program was dedicated to the late Roger Milliken.
If you missed Monday night's Republican presidential debate in New Hampshire, you will have another chance to see it. WYFF4 will re-air the debate between the GOP candidates for president. It will air again on WYFF4.2 and on Charter Channel 136 this Friday at 8 p.m. The debate aired last night on CNN and was produced in partnership with our sister station in New Hampshire, WMUR.
You've probably heard of blind taste tests for things like soda and coffee, but how about tap water? Yep, there was a national taste test to see who has the best of the best. And as News 4's Sean Mazzarello explains new at 6, water coming out of upstate faucets beat out the competition.
There's something different about the water in the Greenville area.
We describe it as the best in the world.
Well, on Tuesday, the Greenville Water System won a national blind taste test, saying it's at least the best tasting H2O in America.
We came out on top.
24 other water providers from as far away as Alaska went up against the Greenville Water System. A sample was pulled for experts to taste at a prominent annual trade conference in Washington, D.C. Then the experts, they took a swig.
That's the funny part about it, is this came out of one of our employees' taps. A water sample that came out of Malden, South Carolina is the best tasting water in the whole nation.
Greenville Water Commissioner Philip Kilgore congratulated some of the water system employees for their part in securing the top honor.
It's just a proud moment for us to know that the men and women who work for the Greenville Water System once again have demonstrated that we have one of the best water utilities literally in the whole nation.
The reason they say their water is so good is not really a secret. They credit the two protected mountain watersheds in the northern part of Greenville County. There's no hunting, boating, or fishing allowed on the water source. You don't get to partake in it until it comes down the pipe. So the next time you turn on the faucet, raise a glass, and know you're drinking the best of the best. Sean Mazzarello, WYFF News 4, Greenville.
And this makes the seventh time the American Water Works Association has held this competition. It's the first win for Greenville.
Now your live Super Doppler 4 HD weather forecast.
Hey, literally just seconds ago, all the severe thunderstorm warnings that we had earlier have been canceled or expired right on time at 6:15 this evening. So no warnings, but these thunderstorms are still quite strong. I'll talk more about that in just a second. However, this is a newly issued warnings. Severe thunderstorm warnings continue for you folks in Clay and Cherokee counties in western North Carolina until 7:15 this evening. All right, let's take a look at the radar. And you can see showers and thunderstorms now starting to weaken considerably. That's still going to produce maybe some small hail, strong gusty winds, maybe around 40 to 45 miles per hour, very heavy rain, and also some lightning as they continue to slide off to the southeast. But these thunderstorms have weakened, at least showing some signs of weakening, but they could redevelop and become severe. So we'll keep you updated on this as these thunderstorms now move out of the mountains and eventually into the northern part of the upstate, just north of I-85. You can see how electrical these thunderstorms were earlier and showing some signs of weakening. Still a lot of lightning, though, associated with these thunderstorms as they continue to slide off to the southeast. So you folks in Nashville in pretty good shape. Very heavy thunderstorm now right over you folks in Hendersonville, moving off to the southeast. And these thunderstorms right over continuing in northwestern part of Greenville County, around Caesar's Head, and northern part of Pickens County, northern Oconee County, all the way back into Rabun County. Very heavy thunderstorm right over you folks in Clayton. So these thunderstorms are just below severe limits. Severe limits would be 1 inch in diameter hail or 58 mile per hour winds or greater. And right now they're just below that. They're still quite strong, but they are not severe. And the National Weather Service will be watching these very closely along with me. And if they issue warnings, we'll relay them to you very, very quickly here this evening. 83 degrees right now in Greenville, 91 in Atlanta, hot 98 in Macon, 95 in Augusta. A lot of heat to our south. Notice the cooler temperatures to the north, especially back into Tennessee, where they've had off and on showers and strong thunderstorms during the day today through this evening. Same story through the mountains. Cooler temperatures with the showers and the thunderstorms, 59 in Franklin, 64 at the Asheville Airport, 61 degrees right now in Boone. And, of course, in the upstate and back into northeastern Georgia where it's dry, it's very warm, if not hot, 92 in Athens right now, 90 in Columbia. So here's what it looks like nationally. Severe thunderstorms continuing out to our west. This watch has been extended as far to the east as including you folks in Rutherford County, on all of Greenville County, and west until 8 o'clock this evening. So they may actually reissue it farther to the east, the Storms Prediction Center out of Oklahoma, a little bit later on, and we'll keep you updated through this evening. So these thunderstorms are going to rumble through mainly from now until midnight. Also, severe thunderstorm watch through most of the peninsula of Florida. Does include Orlando, Tampa, all the way down to Miami. About the heat, 98 in Dallas, 94 in Oklahoma City, and this huge ridge of high pressure is going to, in the upper atmosphere, is going to build in for us as we go into the upcoming weekend and into early next week. Back we go into the middle 90s. All right, so 59 for the overnight low in the mountains, 67 in the upstate. Scattered showers and strong thunderstorms around the area. Thunderstorms producing lots of lightning, large hail damaging winds. And then as we go through the day tomorrow, that front slowly pushes through the area. But we'll probably see showers, maybe a few thunder showers early, and then expect partly sunny skies and somewhat clearing skies by afternoon. Breezy conditions, high temperature 83 in the mountains, 90 in the upstate. We may even drop the humidity levels just a couple of notches tomorrow afternoon. And then the heat and humidity builds back in as we head toward the weekend. Only a slight chance of an isolated afternoon or evening thunderstorm for the upstate. A 30% chance, a little bit better in the afternoon and evening for the mountains, and that goes all the way into the middle of next week.
But a bit toasty, huh?
A bit toasty, yeah.